still trying to cope, okay. I think. Yeah, it's not been easy.
Ah, okay, sure. But you are in the Klang Valley, kan?
Yeah.
Apa, keep yourself apa updated lah, with things, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, Kaine, how are you?
Hi, Ada. Morning, Doctor. I'm fine.
Where are you? Where are you staying?
In my hometown.
Oh, where is that?
Kara.
Kara, I see. Kara is not too bad. Kan? Tapi cuma dia bothering, kan?
Yeah.
Not, dia ada orang Tanggali yang datang lah, and hopefully things will be better lah. Yeah, okay. Are you coping well with the conference and whatnot? Are you coping well? Okay ke?
Yeah.
Okay, just apa ni? Okay, saya ni.
Okay.
Sijong, where are you?
Hi, doctor.
Okay, yeah. Sijong?
Yes.
Where are you?
I'm in Kulai, Johor.
Kulai. Okay.
Yeah.
I've got something to hear that happened. Yeah, Kulai. Kulai should be okay, yeah. It's, but JB is
not so good lah.
Dengar banyak itulah good ya. I wonder what's apa JB, because you have a lot of industrial area as well. I think in Johor,
yeah.
Johor State, Persia. Yeah, okay. So how are you coping? Okay.
Yeah, so far first week okay lah.
It's quite so good lah. Okay, just apa?
Yeah. Come back.
Isam.
Yes.
Isam, are you?
Yes.
Morning. Okay. Where? Okay, morning. Where are you? Where are you staying?
My hometown, Bentong Pahang.
Johor Bahru?
Bentong. Kapahang tu.
Bentong. Abentong is okay. Not too bad. Okay. It's just bothering as well. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really better. But how are you coping? Okay?
Still okay lah.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So, really, I think it'll be better lah. Yiming, Chong Yiming?
Yes, Tom.
Are you okay? Okay, where are you staying?
Seremban.
Oh, Seremban. Seremban. Okay, my grandparents used to stay in Seremban and tapi dah both dah tak ada. My uncles and auntie are still there. But how is Seremban? I've been back for some time since my grandparents tak ada. How is Seremban? Okay?
Okay. It's okay.
Okay. I know. Jadi okay lah Seremban. Not too apa kan? Okay. Okay, then Sok Ling, how
yes,
are
doctor.
You? Where are you?
My hometown.
Where is
Kluang
that?
Johor.
Kluang Johor. Okay, orang Kluang. I think the industrial area pun banyak juga. Kluang, Batu Pahat, what not. Tapi how are things in Kluang? Okay.
Okay.
Okay lah, yeah. Okay, and how are you coping? Okay, so far so good?
Now so far okay. So good.
So far so good lah, yeah. Hopefully things will be better lah. Okay, then thank you. Lavinia, how are you? Look PJ, okay, good.
Good.
I know, I live across the road.
Yeah.
Okay, so far so good. But how are you coping? Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so. Okay. Okay, so far so good ya, Lavinia. Okay, then Minyao, how are you?
Yes, doctor.
Minyao. Okay, morning. Okay, where are you from? Where are you staying?
I'm staying at PJ now.
Oh, PJ, where is that?
Section 16.
Okay, 16. Okay, I think.
Yeah.
Keep there. But how are things? So far so good, yeah.
So far so good.
So far so good. Okay, sure. Okay. Keling Kiyin?
Yes, doctor.
Are you there?
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Okay, where are you staying?
Hometown.
Where is that?
Salike, Sarawak.
Sarawak. Are you now in Sarawak, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. But how are things there?
I think good.
I think okay there.
Yeah, okay.
We cannot see over here. Kan, Sarawak, because kita mana yang kan things being shown, we know lah. Di Sarawak, I'm not so apa kata. But where is Sarike, ya? How far is it from Kuching?
Yeah, no. How to say?
How far is it? Distance?
Very far.
Very far, ya? Okay.
Yeah.
So I've been to Ho Chi Minh, but I've not been. I don't. I'm supposed to go to Binh Tuệ one time, but I didn't go for work. Okay, never mind. Okay, hopefully these things are okay with you, yeah.
Yes.
And come back to us if there's anything that you need. Yeah, you need help that you need. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. Melissa, can you hear us, Melissa? Oh, Melissa, ni satu. Tidak balik Sabah ni. I know. Melissa, tak ada. Okay, nanti. Izzat, ada Izzat? Kau tak ada, tak dengar suara. Izzat?
Ada, Doktor.
Ah, Izzat kat mana? Izzat kat mana? Ya,
pada baru Kedah.
Oh, kat mana? Pantai Baru?
Bandar Baru Kedah.
Bandar Baru Kedah.
Bandar okay. Baru.
Bandar Baru, ya. Okey, tapi macam mana ni? So far, boleh cope, boleh ni, boleh dengar, boleh dapat ni capaian semua dah okey? Untuk belajar, okey?
Boleh, Doktor, boleh.
Ya, yeah, boleh, ya? Okey. Okey. So cope with it, apa kalau ada masalah apa, come back to us. Nanti. Okey, Fawaz, dengar?
Ya,
yeah, Doktor. Ah, okey, Fawaz. Fawaz kat mana?
Kat Jenang Kedah.
Oh, Kedah juga. Ah. Kedah juga. Tapi macam mana capaian semua okey?
So far okey.
Semua okey. Okey. Ya, kalau apa-apa masalah, just come back to us. Hopefully you all ni, then boleh apa? Anything that you like to apa, just come back to us ya. Jangan tak ni, beritahu. Jangan tak beritahu kita.
Okey, okey.
Ya, okey. Afiq Daniel, Afiq, ada? Afiq? Afiq dengar tak? Ah, takut tak dengar lah ni. Saya tak dengar, saya tak cakap ni. Melissa tak dengar. Okay. Kak Iman, okay, how are you?
I'm good, Doktor.
Okay, Kak JB ke?
Tak, saya. Currently dekat apa ni? Rumah my sister, Puchong.
Ah, Puchong. Oh. Okay, so you nak ingin kerenggali lah. Okay, sure. That's better. Okay. Reachable, I mean kan, if there's anything, I think insyaAllah kot apa kalau yang dekat ni. Tapi whenever you want to come over to Yusinaya, I think you have got to get permission, ya?
Yeah.
Yang nak jumpa sekejap, I think there's a form to be filled in, to be given to the dekan, if not Michigan. Yeah. Because you are tak duduk sini kan, you're only coming here to maybe apa, kalau there's anything you got to permit, then you have to have. Tapi kalau ada proper SOP and procedure, nanti we'll just share with you nanti ya. Kalau just in case you all like to apa, to know more.
Boleh
je. Ya, okay. Hafizie Din? Din, ada?
Ada, Doktor.
Ada, okay.
Ada kat mana? Baru lah, Kelantan.
Kota Baru, okay. But how are you coping? Okay tak? Boleh?
Okay, okay. Boleh.
Ya? Yeah? Okay, kalau ada masalah just come back to us. Tam, ya, yeah? Jangan tak beritahu. Ya? Yeah. Okay. Ikhwan?
Ada
tak? Okay. Ikhwan kat mana?
Saya dekat Terengganu.
Terengganu. Okay. Terengganu kat mana tu? Besar Terengganu tu?
Oh, dekat Bukit Payung Mara.
Okay. Macam mana capaian semua okay?
Ya. Yep, so far so good.
Okay, good, ya. And you all are coping well, boleh? Ya?
Boleh.
Ya, tunggu dia apa, boleh ya, insyaAllah. Ya, okay. Okay, Liguan. Liguan, where are you? Tak dengar suara? Liguan, yes. Okay, where are you? Where are you now? Kat mana? Kita tak dengar. Saya tak dengar.
Hello, Doktor. Hello.
Ah, dekat mana?
Ah, sekarang dekat PJ.
Oh, kat PJ. Okey. Ah. Sebab macam dengar tak dengar macam tu.
Rumah sewa.
Rumah sewa. I see. Ah. PJ. Okey, kat mana? Okey, where are you? Section 16. Rumah sewa kat.
Section 16.
Section 16 juga. Okey. Ah. Okey, sebab so far so good lah. Coping well.
So far so good.
Okay, sure. Okay. Okay, Nufadila? Tak dengar suara?
Fadila tak ada.
Tak ada? Okay. Oh, tak ada. Nama je ada. Okay, ya. Sorry. Nama dalam senarai saya tak ni. Syahira? Syahira ada?
Ada, ada.
Ada, okey. Suara macam sayup je. Syahira kat mana?
Dekat Bandar Sri Jempol, Negeri Sembilan.
Oh, okey. Kau Jempol. I see, see. Okey, orang Negeri Sembilan. Saya pun Negeri Sembilan. Okey. Macam mana so far capaian semua okey?
Okey je.
Okey je, yeah. And cooking so okey, yeah. Cooking well also, okay. Yeah. Next year, yeah. Yeah. Kalau apa-apa je siapa, jangan lupa bertanya dan sebagainya. Fazliana? Okey, ya. Yeah. Fazliana ada? Dah, dah. Last meeting pula dia. Okey, tak apa. Fazliana dah masuk balik ke? Ah, dah keluar dah, tak apa. Izwani? Izwani ada?
Ada, doktor.
Ah, okey. Izwani kat mana ni?
Keras.
Kita cerah? Haa,
rumah.
Okey, rumah lah ya. Okey. Saya apa, tapi macam macam dia punya connection apa, macam jauh sangat. Okey, bukan ni kat cerah sebelum lah. Okey, sebab okey lah. Good. Ah, ya. Yeah. Fazliana. Ah, okey, dah masuk balik. Okey, jadi nanti kita talk ya pasal kita punya thesis. Okey. Fazliana, kat mana ni?
Haa, saya dekat JB.
Ah, JB. Macam jauh sangat. Cepat masuk. Macam sayup tadi. Ah, okay, JB.
Tak, saya nak tekan mic, saya tekan tutup and call.
Tutup, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, super sebut ya.
Okay je.
Boleh ya, siapa yang semua okay ya.
Okay.
Izwan ni nanti kita kita contact ya pasal.
Okay.
Ya, Izwan ni super memang sudah. Contact saya, okay. Wahida?
Ya, doktor.
Ada?
Ada.
Wahida daripada, kat mana sekarang ni?
Bagai Serai Perak.
Serai, okey bang. Tapi siapa yang okey? Okey, ya. Okay. Boleh ikut ya so far?
Boleh.
Okey, okey. Apa-apa nanti come back tu. Aini, Kak Serai juga ke? Mana si Aini? Aini, tak ada? Ajar. Eh, saya dulu saya ingat saya always talk kenapa. Saya ingat you only kat cerah. Okay, okay. Kita ajang ya. Tapi okay so far. I think you have been keeping in touch dengan aku. Aku nak kasih hati kena update ni saya kan. Okay. Alia?
Ya,
yes,
saya.
Okay, Alia kat mana?
Seri Iskandar Perak.
Oh, Iskandar. Okay. So far okey? Capaian semua?
Okey je, doktor.
Okey, sure. Ya. Fariza? Fariza ada lagi kan, ya?
Yes, doktor. I'm here.
Ya, okey. Fariza, where are you now? Kat mana sekarang?
In UM.
UM? You duduk UM yourself? Okey, sure. College mana?
Tengah self-isolation kat College
ke-9. Okay, sure. Okay, 9. Tapi dia ada kasih tak where you going to be after this?
Ya. Yeah.
Ini dia baru dia sebut.
Yes. Kat first college.
First college. Okay. Takpelah. Nanti dekat ya. First college. So the thing is, dia punya procedure memang you kena isolate dulu eh. Oh, I think 10 days ke?
Apa tu?
Nak mistaken 10 days ke? Berapa hari isolation?
10 hari.
10 hari kan? Okay. Then you go to your respective office. Okay. Okay, ya. Kalau dia nanti come back. Alamak. Okay. Pua Wei Chi, are you?
Morning, doktor.
Morning. Okay, where are you?
Section
17. Oh, section 17. Dekat saja. Okay. Cuba sebut lah. Siapa yang semua okay.
Yes.
Are you sewa ataupun is your, apa, you are from PJ?
I rent myself.
Aren lah, okay sure. Nah, kalau apa pun kita get. You sound very clear. It should not be a problem ya, yeah, meeting you. Okay. Yeah, okay. Candy.
Yes, doctor.
Where are you, Candy?
I from Sarawak.
Oh, Sarawak. And you are there?
Huh? Yes.
Okay, which part of Sarawak?
Sibu.
Oh, Sibu. Okay, okay, sure. Okay, Sibu, ya. Yeah. Okay, and how is the connectivity? Are you able to capai and apa, the class? Follow the class? Boleh, ya? Yeah?
Yes, no problem.
Okay. No problem, okay. Any problem, just come back to us, ya? Yeah?
Okay.
Bidan? Okay, ya. Yeah. Bidan?
Morning, Doktor.
Morning lah. Wida kat mana sekarang?
Kat Gombak.
Gombak, okey. Rupa okey lah ya, Gombak?
Okey.
And you, hopefully you all are coping well juga eh. So, although kan saya nampak macam dekat dah kita ni. Tapi itulah, you don't know kan how things are. Kalau you all don't tell us, ya. Yeah? Okay, thank you. Suzanne?
Morning, Doktor.
Morning, okay. Where are you?
I stay in JB.
Oh, JB. Oh, yeah. You from JB, yeah? I always thought you from Kelangali. Okay, JB. But so far, so good lah, ya? Yeah? Punya capaian dan whatnot. Okay, sure. Okay, sure. Okay, Basan? Ada tak dia?
Yes, ada? Doktor.
Okay, Basan. Okay. Hello, long time no see and hear from you. Okay, yeah. How are you? Where are you?
In KL, Taman Desa, Doktor. I'm good.
Taman Desa, okay. I know you're here. You've been staying there, eh? All this one, Taman Desa?
Yeah, at my home.
Oh, okay, sure. Okay, definitely going to come back. Because I know you've been, I think you've been coping well during this period of time. Yeah? I think most of the lecturers are saying that you have actually performed. From this, yeah. So, kata tak ada masalah bangun pagi, probably kot. Yeah. Okay, that's what I've been saying. Okay. Tak apa, that's another. Okay. Thank you now. Kayun, where are you?
Morning, Doctor.
Morning, yes.
I'm at Georgetown, Penang.
Oh, Georgetown. You're from Penang, yeah, Kayun?
Ah, yes.
Okay, I didn't know that. Okay, sure. But how things? So, coping so far? Okay.
So far, so good.
Good.
Hey, doctor. Can I ask, tomorrow you free on from 10 to 11 or not? We can meet for the, just now the PA one.
Yeah. Let me see my schedule. Saya kena sekarang banyak meeting. Petang-petang meeting, malam ni. Malam tak meeting. Malam meeting saya ni memarah. Yeah. Tak meeting official. Kalau meeting dengan you all, it's okay. Tanya je lah. Tomorrow, I have... kita ada my meeting. I will be tutorial with you all day. After that, I have another meeting with RSM. Okay, before that, okay. Pukul berapa?
10 to 11.
10 to 11. Okay, kan? 10, ya? 10. Then I put in into my schedule. Give me the link nanti lah, ya?
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Yasmin.
Okay, sure. Where are you now?
I'm at Tanjung Karang, my hometown.
Oh, Tanjung Karang. Tapi itulah Selangor.
Selangor, yes.
Banyak case kan? So a bit apa sikit lah, cautious sikit kita.
Yeah.
Hopefully you coping well and apa boleh ya? Boleh ni. Boleh
cakap dengan so.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Amira? Yeah. Amira ada?
Yeah, ada Doktor.
Amira kat mana sekarang?
Bulu Yam baru.
Bulu Yam?
Bulu
Yam, okay. Kampung bapak mentua saya tapi dah tak ada dah dia. Bulu Yam, okay. Saya tahu tempat tu eh. Tapi dah banyak kali pergi. Okay, so far capaian okay?
Okay, dia.
Okay, sure. Okay, berapa nanti come back to us, ya? When you? Where are you?
Morning, Doctor.
Morning, okay. Where are you?
KL.
KL, where are you staying?
Beside the KL Gateway.
Oh, I see. So you've gone out of the campus lah, ya?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. Okay. But there's any problem, come back to us, yeah? So you used to live inside, in the college. So, you know, it's a bit easier lah. We know where you are. There's anything, please come back to us, yeah? Okay?
Okay.
Okay, sure. Okay, then, to switching. Switching ada?
Yes, Doctor.
Okay. Switching kat mana sekarang?
PJ, di rumah.
PJ, This is your, you say work ke, it's your home?
It's my home.
Oh, your home lah. Okay. Yeah. Which part, which section, yeah, teaching?
SS23.
SS23, okay. Damansara Utama?
Damansara.
Oh, Damansara, okay, sure. Siapa saya tak panggil lagi tadi ya? Nazri ada? Tak ada dengar juga. Melissa?
Yes, tak.
Melissa? Melissa? Okay, Melissa can hear us?
Yes.
Masih ada dengar sayup je. Melissa?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, finally can hear your voice. Melissa di mana? Panampang?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay. And how is the connectivity so far? Okay.
So boleh? Unless okay, it's
raining, then. Uh-huh, okay, sure. Yeah. Because saya dengar ni macam a bit apa juga. Saya dengar from from this side lah. From my side. Kenapa? Just to tell you all. Mesti Melayu punya connectivity pun not as good as what we hope. Ya. Yeah. Kadang-kadang ada saya dengar classes lah, ada yang lecturer complain yang terputus dan sebagainya. Yeah. I'm using the PC ya, yeah, punya connectivity, not the wireless. Wireless lagi apa di Mesti Melayu ni, lagi teruk. Ya. Yeah. Afiq Daniel ada? Tak dengar suara? Okay, tanya Melissa. Ya. Yeah. Apa-apa saya come back ya Melissa?
Okay.
Ya. Afiq Daniel? Tak ada. Kita tak ada. Afiq Daniel, ke saya kan tak panggil pula. Siapa lagi saya tak panggil? Siapa lagi saya tak panggil? Just I like to just get some updates on how you all are. How are you all coping? Ya, yeah? Connectivity macam mana? Ya, yeah? Do come back to us. Ya, yeah? any apa ni? Ya. Yeah? Kalau boleh jangan apa ni. Okey. Adiba. Adiba, okay Adiba. Oh Adiba,
yes.
Join. Yeah, Adiba masuk join this class ya. Okay,
yes.
Saya tak masuk. Yeah, okay.
And Adiba kat mana? I mean saya berjaya, doktor.
Saya berjaya, okay.
Yep.
Saya berjaya. Okay, saya take note. Saya pun dalam senarai saya tak ni. Okay, kat nanti should be okay ya, saya berjaya.
Okay je.
Yeah. Okay, sudah, okay. Okay, ada siapa lagi? Anyone else? Nanti saya nak ni update my cuma saya tak dapat senarai lagi ya. Because I hopefully and I just like to check, are you all able to register for the course? Because saya takut ada juga yang ada masalah and then tell us ya. Beritahu kami that this can be sorted out. For the new Maya system ni there's always some apalah hiccups ya. Hiccup with the okay. Yeah, that is one part of our introduction this morning. Yeah.
Dr. Yasmin, Chua Tianwan
here. Chua, okay. Yeah. Okay, Chua.
Yeah, doctor. Morning.
Morning. So you're joining this class, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, sure. So I'll put you in. Where are you staying, Chua?
Makota Cheras. Kajang.
Oh, you're in Cheras lah, Bukit Makuta.
Yeah.
In Cheras lah. Okay, so I'll put your name in also. Yeah. Okay, tak apa ya. So, apa, hopefully kalau apa, register for the course, you can be able to do so. Register ya. So, kita nak ni. Okay, then that's it. Kita dah sorted out that part. Okay, now we'll go to the, ni lah, for the course punya information.
Doctor.
Yes. Kenapa?
Lee Wen Ye is having a problem for registering course.
I see. Okay. The thing is actually registration ni kalau boleh you go to Dr. Sihati or Puan Izan. Yeah. Tell them the registration. Yeah. Kalau boleh. Because individually kami tak ni because they apa they will take note for the whole apa whole department punya course punya registration and try to find out kenapa ada masalah dengan apa ni lah. Yeah. Tapi itulah kalau you all just Pak Iman, since you are a class rep, nanti kumpulkan ya yeah, pelajar-pelajar ada masalah for all the courses that you're trying to register. Personal sikit ya, yeah. that's one master list. Jangan satu-satu pening kepala actually. Ya, yeah, to tackle. Ya. Yeah. So try to register the courses that you all intend to take. And then kalau ada masalah, then put up the apa, the list ya. Yeah. And then berikan kepada Dr. Sihati dengan Puan Izan. You all boleh contact ya Puan Nizam Mak Saman. Nizam Mak Saman. Yeah. Kalau boleh kita padu dan jangan datang sikit-sikit sikit nanti semua bukan apa. We want to pantau as well ya. Yeah. Kalau boleh. pemantauan tu apa would be better eh kalau kita ada the whole complete list. Nah, sikit nak complain. Tapi cuma hopefully the system can be apa ada department susu di apa ada student ada department susu complaining juga kan. So, tapi you all understand there's a hiccups the new system ya for the administration and many other things lah the system is supposed to do. Yeah. Okay, so for today kita go through the course information, performa and apa a bit of the lecture. Cuma saya takut I have something at 10:30 ya. Saya takut tak sempat, kita boleh sambung tomorrow lah ya. Okay. Buat to attend another function on behalf of your dekan pula ya. For this morning. Tak apalah. I'll do what I can ya. Problem. Okay, saya akan cuba try to share with you the kan performa. Sekejap ya, saya tengok. You all nampak tak skrin?
Yes, doktor.
Okay. Okay, you all nampak performa ke?
Yes, doktor.
Okay, ya, performa. You nampak performa aja ya. Okay, this is actually the particulars ya of apa of what you're going to go through. Be looking into the scope principles of marketing. Looking into the concept of apa kan, real asset practice according to the regulations, relate the principle real asset marketing practice. Yeah, here we're looking into communication skill, critical thinking, problem solving, lifelong information management punya skill. Yeah, so we just like to give you some foundation of the marketing, knowledge of marketing in the asset. So I'll be going through with you the marketing punya management punya concept. And I think we have a part-timer, part-time lecturer, part-timer, we call her Puan Sharifah Azhar. She was the one that founded the department sebenarnya. She has been an old staff yang telah meninggalkan perkhidmatan lah, but we call her in because of her apalah, expertise and her exposure in estate agency. She be coming into you all and go through the real estate agency punya profession lah and what does estate agent does ya. Yeah. Tapi cuma is apa being us ya, yeah, kalau kita duduk sini kita cover only 14 weeks ya, yeah, but there's so many things to do sebenarnya for us to there's so many things to be done ya, yeah, sebenarnya nak tahu ya. To me actually one semester tak cukup ya, yeah, untuk saya dah share with you all kan. For you to learn valuation, property management, estate agency, research within this 3 years that being given to you sebenarnya tak sepanjang yang diperlukan sepatutnya ya. That's why masa you all go for your internship, try to get the exposure that you can to cover all the various aspect of the practice ya for a property person ya, kalau dapat. So much better kalau dapat a firm that can expose you to do that, be better. Tapi tak apa. Ya, kalau dapat any placement pun tak apa, it's good for you. Exposure can come throughout the years that you're going to do the practice. Yeah. Okay, that's one. Yeah. Then I'm going to share with you another ni. Yeah. The course information. Yeah. Nampak tak? Sekejap ya. Nampak tak di yang ni? Maklumat semasa?
Yes, doktor.
Nampak ya? Okay, sure. Okay, these are the particulars of the course. Saya dah juga masuk upload dalam kita punya apa UM Spectrum, ya. Yeah. So be taken by me and Sharifah Azhar, Puan Sharifah Azhar. And our classes are on Wednesday and Thursdays, ya. Yeah. Just to highlight to you kan, the apa assessment that we're going to go through. Because this particular course, ya, yeah, dia punya penilaian terusan 40% and peperiksaan akhir 60%, ya. Yeah. So there'll be one test in week 11. There'll be one coursework Nanti saya kasih soalan akan diberikan besok lah, saya kasih lah ya soalan so that you all can prepare yourself. It to be done in a group. Yeah, so pandai-pandailah cari your apa ni apa your group numbers. And your final examination will comprise of 60% will be kan periksaan secara online exam. And reflection note. Yeah. Okay, reflection note is actually a note to be given. Reflection of what you have done. Throughout the apa ada nanti ada dia punya sort of guided information that are required in reflection note will be given to you ya earlier. Yeah, and then the question will be given to you in week 14 to be submitted back lah within maybe the time frame given. Yeah. Okay, the exam I don't know whether whether there be apa ni minggu revision ya given to you as of schedule tu saya tak pasti lagi ya. Kalau ada I'll be sharing to you. Ya, kalau ada. So, sekarang kami masih apa ni. So these are the schedule of the topic that will be going through from week 1 until week 7 I'll be bringing you through sampai minggu 7 ya. And Puan Sharifah Azhar will come in and apa and pick up the essay agency pun part. Cuma I think during this period yang minggu 8 ke atas ada banyak public holidays ya. We have taken that into account. Yeah. So these are some of the topics being covered. Yeah. And your midterm, mid-term break will be after week 10. Saya rasa masa cuti hari raya lah ya. Yeah. That week ada kan ada day. So scheduling of the apa kami cuba masukkan scheduling of the lectures and apa ni tutorial tapi cuma cuma saya nampak during banyak holiday ni lah. This is the period yang banyak holiday. Yeah, I think after your break, there'll be one test. Yeah, and then the submission of your assignment. And finally, I think by week 14, we'll be giving you the reflection note in the question. Yeah. So this is actually something that we have planned throughout for this particular kursus lah for this semester. Ya, kalau apa-apa, I think just go to the information yang saya dah letak dalam spectrum. Ya. So that's one. Okay. Kita dah habis. Okay, now. Okay, dah. Ini nak dekat ke 10 lah, tak apa. So for a start, I'm going to go through to you the first apa lecture. Like before, the recording of the lecture, I'll be also putting in spectrum. Yeah, just in case you'd like to hear back again of what we have covered, saya dah pecahkan into smaller apa videos for you to just add your apa your masa yang lapang luang ke dengarlah ya sambil nak tu nak sedekat faham. But I would rather if you all can get a copy of the marketing buku marketing ya just to apa make yourself familiar of what we are going through ya. Pada saya pembacaan adalah penting sebenarnya. It's good to read. Yeah. I have time to read. Maybe dalam internet boleh tengok. Tapi saya rasa it's good to go through a good book. Yeah. And I've always nak kata puji apa. I look forward to books. Management. Yeah. Management and marketing books are good. Provided by professors from US, United States. I don't know because economy dia is a capitalist economy and whereby, you know, there's so many things are being done there. Saya suka baca buku management and buku marketing from professors in the United States of America. British punya professors a bit apa sikit. I don't know, dia a bit theoretical dan sebagainya. Tapi bila baca buku-buku Amerika, saya suka bagas dia banyak example, case study dan sebagainya. Ada opportunity, try to get the book that I've recommended. Dia cuma itulah, kalau di sini dia go to library and pinjam. Online tak, I don't know whether it's available for you to apa, to be able to do so. Yeah. Okay, dan saya apa nak tengok dalam kino. Yeah. Nampak screen tak? Are you able to see the screen?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. So I think like what I mentioned just now, okay, it's just the first lecture. I'll be going to with you kan the introduction part. and mentioned about the division of what I'm going to take, and the other part is going to be taken up by Kojai Plaza. Yeah, and for this particular week, we're looking into overview of marketing and how they relate sikit to property. Okay, outline this lecture, kita define marketing, discuss the core concept, and also a bit of philosophy lah. Kita sekarang dekat universiti kan, kalau universiti, what is the difference between us belajar dekat universiti dengan sekolah? Kita kena ada a bit apalah, ada konsep-konsep, philosophy, kita kena faham ya. Ini us macam nampak lebih sikit lah daripada apa yang kita selalu belajar di apa kan, because I hope that you all ada belajar sikit about the thinking part. Thinking part of us now kan should be able to do sebab kita dah masuk universiti. Okay, differentiate the parts of marketing process and how they relate to each other and applications with property marketing. Yeah, kalau orang ingat marketing ni sebab adik saya did a degree in United States in marketing. She was used to be as in brand manager dekat Smith & Beecham yang for Ribena, for Holic, one time. Saya tanya dia, marketing ni macam sales ke? No, dia kata, marketing is not doing selling. Not just, dia part of selling. Dia ada selling, but it's just not that, ya. Marketing is actually a bigger, sebab saya tanya dia, belajar marketing as a degree? Saya macam, ya, yeah, bukan marketing boleh, siapa boleh belajar ke? No, dia kata. Marketing is actually a very huge subject and selling and sales is just part of it. Ya, yeah, jangan kita try to relate kata marketing is macam sales and selling. It's a different aspect, ya. Philip Kotler, this professor which I actually envied for many years, ya, Philip Kotler. He is actually an economist who has used some of the principles of economics to marketing and management. Dia ambil konsep of economics and management to make sure that marketing also has some of that particular concept and aspect and make it much more concept yang lebih luas dan strategik. Not just purely selling. As an agency pun, orang kata macam selling saja, tak apa. Kita discuss about that nanti later. The simple definition of marketing, kalau Chartered Institute of Marketing kata, is a management process, nampak sini pakai management. Responsible for identifying, anticipating and satisfying customer requirement profitably. Profit mesti ada, nampak at the end. At the end of the day, you like to get some money and profit out of the activities that you are doing. Because our main goal is to attract new customer by promising superior value, keep and grow current customer by delivering satisfaction. Yeah, because our mission of the marketing is that not just by just selling one product, that's it, habis dah kerja kita. Yeah, because we hope by just doing that phase of selling, we'll be expanding further and getting, not just keeping our current customer, but hoping to get new customer because of the things that you have actually exchanged with that particular customer. Yeah, the things that you have changed can be in terms of goods, services, experience, and sebagainya. This will be that later. Yeah. Okay, Kotler kata ada professor. Dia kata ni, marketing is a process by which companies create value for customers and build strong customer relationships in order to capture value from customer in return. Yeah, apa value the customer can give in return? Dia boleh kasi recommendation kepada kawan-kawan untuk beli lagi produk kita, can keep coming back to you to buy more, apa lagi dia boleh do many, sekarang dah in the social media punya pasar, but you can tell good things about the product or services that you have provided by your customers yang satisfied, that's the value that you can actually capture from your customer. What marketing is not, mentioned today, is neither selling or brokerage. Because selling involves listing, prospecting, negotiating, closing. Itu macam kerja as an agent je saya nampak. Okay, so I would say that as an agency has the main elements of being sales, but can also include principles of marketing. You nampak di sini. Okay, marketing involves management process. Okay, tadi saya mention identifying, anticipating, satisfying customer requirement and making a profit. Okay, memang involve this. Okay, what is being marketed? Yeah, kita punya goods, services, yeah, experiences, events, properties. Yeah, kita market property. Yeah, organisation, information, ideas, places. Yeah, macam tourism. Apa dia market? Kan? Besides experience, places. Yeah, maybe they can also kan? Boleh juga market macam-macam. Yeah. Okay, the marketing process, these are some, it's mentioned here as five processes. First, to understand marketplace and customer needs and wants. Then, you can design a customer-driven marketing strategy. Ini, nanti kita go through this. How do you design this marketing strategy? Yeah. People has actually confused. Dia kata marketing strategies comprise of the four P's. Nanti kita deliberate further. Jika you dah tahu apa four P's tu, nanti kita go through. Because four P's tu are just the tools. But strategy ni, dia lebih luas dia sebenarnya. Okay, how do you strategize to do an event? Itu maknanya kita kena do some planning, organizing. Yeah? Macam kita go through our management apa nah, class. Yeah? Yeah. Thirdly, kena construct integrated marketing program that delivers superior value. Proses keempat, build profitable relationship and create customer delight. And fifth, you kena capture value from customer to create profit and customer equity. Yeah. So this one ni nampak you macam mana nak create value for customer and build relationship, and towards the end, how do you actually capture value from customer in return at the end. So these are some of the apa lah. Yeah. Okay, then saya dapat message untuk pukul up another meeting je. Yeah? Okay, cuma okay, now we'll go into the core marketing concept. Yeah, okay, dalam diagram ni kita nampak ada five main elements. Yeah, whereby konsep yang pertama utama yang kita harus faham, kita ada needs, wants and demands. You kena really know your customer needs, wants and demands. Yeah. Secondly, okay, what is being offered? Marketing offers apa? Apa you like to market tu? Yeah, product, services, experiences. Yeah. Thirdly, there'll be value and satisfaction also being involved. Yeah, you kena faham, cuba faham apakah nilai yang diletakkan, macam mana your customers are being satisfied. Kat mana nak cari nilai tersebut? Oh, ini kan orang buat pemasaran, wow. Kita cari nilai pula ya, kita belajar valuation, proxy valuation. Kat sini kita cari nilai juga in the process of the marketing, dalam marketing concept. Dalam pemasaran kita ada exchange, transaction, relationship. Kita ada pertukaran, kita ada kan transaction being involved. Relationship pula kita buat berhubungan juga dengan kita punya pelanggan-pelanggan. And market, you got to understand the market. Kita ada property market, ya, kita ada atau market yang basah tu, jual ikan, sayur dan sebagainya. Okay, what is actually your market? Kena be able to understand. So, dalam market ni adalah segmentation, positioning dan sebagainya. Nanti you go to that later. Yeah, so, these are the sub, this is a very core marketing concept that kita harus faham, ya. Yeah? Okay, ni saya mentioned, cuma tadi saya kata market tadi, target, target market, positioning, segmentation. Okay, we'll go into that data. Yeah. Okay, understanding the marketplace and customer needs is something which is very, very important. Yeah, because the basic concept to faham human needs. Kalau you all masih ingat the Maslow hierarchical triangle of needs tu. Yeah, whereby you see the level of progression of the basic physical needs. Yeah. And then it goes up, human needs to goes up to the social, individual needs dan sebagainya. Kita tengok, these are some of the things that you may want to identify for what you're going to offer. Tengok customer kita ni kat mana dia punya needs tu. Yeah? And then there is one, shaped by culture, individual personality, and when backed by buying power, wants become demand. Kita belajar, demand and supply. This also comes in, yeah. Kita kata kalau dia kendak, memang kendak ni semua orang ada macam-macam kendak, ya. Dia punya needs ni selalu kita fikir of state of felt deprivation. Kita betul perlukan keperluan kita. Apa kita perlu? kita boleh makan bila lapar. Nah, kita berada kita, kita nak tempat berteduh, ya. Apa-apa tempat berteduh pun tak apa. Masa kita rasa the basic human needs being apa, satisfied. Bila kita nak human wants, kehendak kita, a form that a human needs takes as shaped by culture, individual personality. Just as society evolves, the wants of members expand. Ya, kalau kita nampak, satu telah membangun, kan, Malaysia sedang dalam satu apa negara yang membangun. Kalau dah dibangunkan, develop country as United States or UK, dia nampak dia punya kehendak dah berbeza. Kan? So dia nampak, you try to understand what society wants. Yeah? People may have narrow basic needs, but maybe almost unlimited ones. Yeah? And when human wants are backed by buying power, that can be turned into the demand. Yeah, tengok, bila dia ada buying power, nampak these are the demands by my customers. Yeah. Because you tahu kan, dia punya, this way you got to, kalau you belajar property market research, you got now to understand the capability of the apa kan, of the society, of the community or society or the target market that you going to target for. Then macam mana dia punya buying power? What will be the income punya punya gap dan sebagainya. Yeah. Okay, then dalam understanding marketplace customer needs, you may want to look into the market offering. What are the products, services, experiences that you're going to offer? Yeah, because customer needs and wants study can be fulfilled by your products, services and experiences. Yeah, your market offering. Apa kita nak meletakkan di pasaran tersebut? Yeah, kita punya produk, services, experiences. Yeah. Okay, company address needs by establishing a value proposition, okay, whereby what would be the set of benefits that, that they want to promise to customers to satisfy the needs. Yeah, what are you going to propose? Nah, dalam nilai apa yang kita akan apa letakkan? Yeah, and then this value proposition is fulfilled through the market offering, through the combination of product and services, information or publication offer to apalah to satisfy the needs of what? Yeah, so that market offering tu you kena make sure that you clear of what you going to offer. Yeah, and you must also try to understand customer value and satisfaction. Yeah, customer dia ada some form. Macam kita as customer, kita may want to expect something. Yeah, in terms of the apa satisfaction that kita may want to derive from certain product yang kita beli. Kalau saya beli TV, saya nak tengok TV bukan tengok harga jugalah ya. Takkan you expect harga yang murah tu dapat dapat gambar yang sharp and apa all this ada HD bagai dan ni kan. So kita tengoklah juga with the level apa. So something expectation saya punya expectation tu ada tentang nilai satu barang yang saya beli. Apa ni dengan satisfaction yang saya harap juga that you can offer to me. So you all live on apa lah. So you all kan pandai belajar to understand your customers. Yeah. So marketers must be careful to set the right level of expectation. Yeah. So kita tengok kalau Mr. Tony Fernandez letak di logo for Air Asia, everybody can fly. Tapi cuma not now lah during the pandemic, nobody can fly. Tapi cuma tu lah, that expectation of dia kata everybody can fly at low punya kan, price punya ni, ticket price. So kita punya expectation, we wouldn't want to expect the services to be as good as Malaysian airline, yeah, probably. Yeah, so this is something that kita kena ponder. Yeah. Okay, and customer make buying choices based on their perception and value that the various product and services deliver. Yeah, and customer value is based upon customer assessment of the product overall capacity to satisfy. And so customer value tu kita tengok because it's just your pelanggan punya penilaian ke atas capacity produk kita. Okay, then exchange relationships. Yeah, marketing occurs when people decide to satisfy needs and wants to exchange relationship. Yeah, apa ke exchange? Yeah, the act of obtaining desired object from someone but offering something in return. Kita buat pertukaran ya, yeah, exchange. Tapi dalam exchange tersebut kita also build relationships. Because the goal is to retain your customers and grow their business with the company. Yeah. Marketers want to build strong relationship by delivering superior customer value. Yeah. Okay, so I mentioned today, more transaction is a marketing organization unit of measurement. So transaction is a trade between two parties. Involve two things of value agreed upon conditions dan agreement and place of agreement. Kita transaction tu dibuat di mana, kat mana, bila, kenapa condition dia, maybe sekarang dia berharga. Dulu kita baca barter system tu tukar batu dengan pen. Adakah saya value batu atau saya value pen? Kita tengoklah dulu barter system lah. Sekarang kita dah ada ni apa kan, duit. Oh, di medium exchange kan, macam lagi Bitcoin dan sebagainya. Okay, how do customer obtain product and services? Okay, this is through the itulah, exchange and transaction and ship. So this is something which you got to make sure. Tapi itulah sekarang network of the exchange tu sekarang dah sophisticated. Mungkin saya mungkin ask you all to get the latest ways of doing transaction and share with the whole class. Kalau boleh, ya. Maybe later kita go through this, Okay, now talk about market. Apa dia pasar? The set of actual and potential buyer of a product. And the buyer share particular needs of one that can be satisfied through exchange relationship. Marketing will be managing this market to bring about the profitable customer relationship. And for you to create this relationship that works, ni apa memang perlukan effort, takes work, whereby you got to do a bit of consumer research. Siapa kita punya consumer, kat mana dia, berapa tahap gaji dia, berapa umur sekarang, what types of product services that you like to so now kalau you are doing something to market, katalah you looking for developer in the marketing punya section, you kena do a bit of the market customer research to find out more. And product development probably. Tapi product development kalau kat developer mainly will be comprising all the technical team as well. The architects and engineers and sebagainya. Because this involves a lot of other things to develop the housing unit. Communication, solution, pricing, service, this will be under the sales team. Are the core marketing activities. So this is where, you got to create relationship to make things work, Okay, our market, just dalam simple marketing system, nampak you ada industry that does the collection of the selling part, and the market will be collection of the buyers who like to have that product. There's the exchange being made in between, the product and money being exchanged, There's communication involved for you to wawarkan information as well to be made, kalau kita buat brochure dan sebagainya, Jadi something just a simple marketing system punya So market ni banyak, consists of all potential customer sharing particular need or want, who might be willing and able to exchange in, engage in exchange to satisfy that need or want, Okay, who would we call as potential market? They have sufficient level of interest. Available market, siapa ada interest, income, access to the particular offering. Target market, because that company can go for serving the whole market or concentrate certain segment. Because sometimes in the market, there's so many competitor, Because banyak, kadang kita wonder, mana kita nak masuk, So you must be able to find a target market, and you must be able to know how do you enter that target market. And how do you go about doing all this the whole your process of doing marketing that particular target market. Tapi target market tu you kena really do a study, And penetrated market memang the set of buyers yang currently buying your product, and how do you keep them? That's very important. Dan nak pergi to your competitor, Okay, this modern marketing system. In between you nampak sekarang what comes in ada competitor, ada marketing intermediaries. Nampak? So marketing sendiri siapa dia? Can be the estate agent, can be the lawyers, can be the bankers providing finance dan sebagainya, Can be the local authority, looking into the permission to pasang your board, to for sale dan sebagainya. And then major environmental process lah, nanti we go to into the environment later, Dia banyak lah. Cuma dalam ni ada taxes being involved, the government also coming in. Ada kan kalau retailing sekarang government pun come in to apa ni tengok how to do some market protection. Takutnya di apa maybe international market comes in ya and apa the business of the local. Jadi saya sama dia apa market dah gets much more sophisticated. And you trying to deal with the, what you like to sell and market to sell. Key customer ni, key customer market customer, saya fokus on customer je lah. Biar kita jangan banyak sikit actually banyak ada market yang lain. The customer market, that's global market, business market, consumer market, and government market. So just kita tengok to focus on customer market je lah. Okay, the orientation philosophy of the firm typically guides marketing efforts. Several competing orientation entities. Kita ada production concept, product concept, selling concept, marketing concept, customer concept dan societal marketing concept. Ini saya kata filosofi yang kita harus faham tentang marketing. Yang tapi pada saya, apalah kita cuba faham sajalah ya. Because I do not want you to dwell more of this. Tak apalah, ini kalau siapa nak buat thesis, maybe at PhD level ke probably ya. Can try to look at the philosophy of what the marketing is trying to understand. Okay, so five marketing philosophy underpin ya property marketing management. Ya, kita tengah bercakap tentang pengurusan pemasaran, mengurus pemasaran sebenarnya, pengurusan pemasaran. Ya, and each correspond to a marketing concept. Ya, so product develop semua pada saya lah. This for my observation. Ya, property developers adopt product or production philosophy as a marketing foundation. Ya, apakah dia? Okay, nanti saya akan apa ni? Elaborate further ya. This ada five marketing management philosophy. Saya kata just go through ya. Saya sebenarnya saya tak tanya pun. Saya nak just you all maybe have some apalah, some understanding sikit ya. Faham sikit tentang philosophy di bawah pengurusan pemasaran. Kalau kita look into production concept, philosophy dia punya assumption is that consumer prefer product in the market that affordable to them. In other words, consumer will buy product that will be in the market but are also cheap. Ini selalunya reflect mass production, especially during industrial revolution many years ago. Ya, sebab masa tu saya rasa kemampuan pelanggan pun tak tinggi ya. Dia mampu undi beli certain of product yang keperluan yang ada. Ya. So this philosophy lebih I think reflect mass production. And with this mass production, price can be reduced and more people can afford the product. Kan tapi cuma okay, production concept ni cuma kita fikirlah apa yang kita nampak ya, yang some companies are still doing adopting this concept ya, production concept. Nak kata pencil pun sekarang saya nampak pencil pun dah canggih ya. Ada so many ways to check. Sekarang pencil pun tak ni sebab people are now using apa ada social di gadgets ya, electronic gadgets ya, sebenarnya. The product concept, in this assumption, consumer favor product of higher quality performance and excellent indicators. Yes. So with this product concept, so companies that have this implication is that they devote effort to continuous improve production technique so that better products can be offered in the market. So they focus on the product. Macam Apple lah, I would see what it does, from apa so. Many years ya, they try to innovate and come up with better product. Tapi pada saya in the market sekarang banyak dah China product is coming to the market ya, to compete with Apple. Tapi up to you to see ya, the competition being made lah in terms of apa. But it all depends on consumer juga ya, on the punya consumer. Customer that they have so far, are they loyal customers ya? They really want to just get the best of everything ya, because they value the quality, performance and excellent innovative features tadi. Selling concept, okay, this classic assumption that consumer will not buy enough product unless a company initiate more grand sales and promotion. This company, they engage nyaman selling sajalah dia punya ni. Because kata they will engage selling concept when they face problem or excess stock during customer decision not to buy. So selalunya dia will try to do hard selling, aggressive selling to coach customer to buy produknya aja. So this concept is still suitable for product that not commonly sought by customers such as insurance and funeral plot. Kalau kita beli insurance, kita nak tak kalau kita nampak kita nak beli? Somebody has got to sit down with us and convince us to say that no, this particular kan macam insurance ni is something which is good for us. And I had to be convinced actually sebenarnya for somebody to come over and ask me to buy an insurance policy. Yeah, so it's something yang memang you kena do a lot more of the selling concept. Marketing concept, yeah, consumer, dia punya philosophy, consumer be loyal to the company on condition company can satisfy the needs and wants better than other firms in the market. Yeah, selalunya company, dia punya ni, dia will initiate the study of needs and wants of the target market. Yeah. Then produce product based on the research funding so that this product can meet the customer wants. So saya rasa banyak actually companies that hold this customer orientated punya philosophy. I think they have adopted this concept, yeah. Most of the company has done that. And finally, societal marketing concept. Dia punya assumption that societal marketing is a new concept among all the management philosophy we discussed earlier. Say that firm doing business within the community framework and their marketing entity should not only deliver value but also for the community welfare. So, saya rasa banyak juga company that have taken up this societal marketing concept. Yeah. Kalau boleh, especially macam dia ambil green punya approach of looking into product dia, can save the environment dan sebagainya. Yeah. Not just kan maximizing profit and looking into customer satisfaction apa, but they also look into what they can apa ni, can add on to the society, yeah, in the longer run. Saya banyak multinational companies ya, yeah, yang from the developed countries are actually adopting this societal marketing concept. Because I do have one of my ex student that did a master punya ni, she did ni apa kan, looking into how the occupiers of green office building appreciate ya, the occupation dekat office building sebab dia appreciate ya, dia apa ni, ada apalah, maknanya green building tu is actually a product of trying to satisfy kan a certain society punya value system ya, so that you can save the environment for the community. Itu yang kita apa, some apa aspect yang kita boleh apa faham ya. Okay, saya dah tabulate ya the marketing concept and its philosophy and the suitability of affinity ya for the concept yang ada ya. When kita rasa kita can use this various marketing concept between production, product, selling, marketing and selective marketing. So kalau ada masa baca ya. Okay, ini siapa? Okay, cycle marketing concept looks into human welfare, not just the one satisfaction and profit ya, yang kita just have look into before. This is a case of Daimler Chrysler. Dia exhibit cycle marketing by investing in technology because those yang value society, they will do a bit more in investment ya, of the technology yang ada lah, kalau tengok depending lah on some technology companies lah ya. I don't know macam Microsoft punya kan Bill Gates ya, dia dah taken another level of apa, trying to do more for the society sebab dia dah kaya lah. Probably more what Microsoft can do lah ya. So now we know that marketing dah evolve ya, dah banyak change especially internet age ya, sekarang ada shopping online ya. Ada social responsibility, ethics, there's a global marketplace, there's a green punya initiatives dan awareness being apa put up. So, you know, there's many things that actually you got to take into account. Yeah. This is some of the kind of technology comes in, like increased competition, globalization, and expectation of the product and services that like to put on to the market. Yeah. So consumer information, so saya nampak information tu is very very critical in you trying to analyze the market and analyze what your customer needs and wants. Okay, application towards property marketing. Yeah, these are some of the goals because kita nak maximize consumption, kalau boleh ya, satisfaction, siapa tak nak ya, kalau boleh dapat sejapat tinggi pencapaian apa ni, satisfaction, choices yang kita boleh offer, life quality, profit, siapa tak nak ya, kita increase our profit and market share. There's also kan competitiveness, kita nak being, kita boleh kita be the one ya, the very apa, top in the market ya, competition as well, and we like to have called boleh long-term survival. Yeah, I always ponder and try to wonder some companies yang ada kan, apa Fashion Valley, maybe New Rupa, siapa yang ni lah, actually the ladies, yeah, Malay ladies, wonder kan, they are so young, yeah, and they are very successful, but what be their long-term survival? So this are things yang kita apa kan, kalau in the market and try to think of somebody macam saya wonder macam KFC, McDonald's and what not, they've been there, tapi dia orang ada lah another form of business structure, yeah, because they are under franchise. Yeah, so kita wonder kan, for a company to be surviving long, cuma I don't know whether you all ni ya, know about this product hot dog, yeah, one time. I know kan that Tengku Zarida was the founder, tapi itulah, it doesn't last that long, yeah, that product, hot dog tu, for a while, then it went down out of the market. So cuma long-term survival is something which I think that's very, very important, yeah, in understanding and trying to keep up and survive, yeah, in apa, marketing your product. Okay, evaluation property marketing, because kita ada banyak juga dalam function yang kita buat dalam property marketing, yeah. There are these two main function, exchange function, facilitating function. Exchange function ni apa kita tengok, yeah? Kita tengok activities involve transfer of title to goods and to the goods and delivery of services. Maknanya kita ke dalam property, kita buat kan exchange, pertukaran daripada pembeli kepada daripada penjual kepada pembeli. Kita memang buat proper exchange, kan? Tapi dalam tu kita kena tengok kan, kan bila pertukaran jadi, apakah aktiviti yang harus kita ambil kira. Ini something yang kita kena faham, ya. Kita punya role tu besar sebenarnya. Ataupun you are working for the developers, kan. Ya, because dalam exchange tu kita tengok, kita nak make sure that the ownership of the property that we're going to do in the exchange function tu can be transferred properly, ya, to the pembeli. Yeah, you got to. You got to have that knowledge of, you know, what to do. Yeah, in the process of, there's also the facilitating function lah, activities that make possible the smooth performance of the exchange function. Whereby dalam pertukaran property yang kita nak deliver kan tadi, kita tengok into the legal services, the credit arrangement, bila tak dia dapat apa kan, dapat akhirnya loan ya, daripada bank. Dapat tak legal services, the lawyer tu apa, to complete the transaction, ya. Because dalam tu you kena make sure that tak ada caveat, ownership punya kan, transfer tu properly done, ya, so at the end memang dia, you finally your purchaser will be satisfied with the whole process, ya. Okay, hopefully you still remember the characteristics of real estate, ya, and how it can relate to marketing. Immobility, accessibility, and durability, yeah. Community is not standardized, large amount of money, legality, market size, and length of marketing, yeah. Okay, this one, these are some of the characteristics, yeah. Kita, I think kita dah belajar, I think I don't know whether it's being apa given to you in your first year, kan? Estate durable, can last for the building, tengok the building and the land. That's why you selalu try to always ask you all to explain, yeah, to those who may not be aware. Dan kadang property tu dia comprises of one, yeah, that's the land. Kalau ada bangunan atasnya, okay, the building as well. Yeah, the building. Building tu may all depends. Because some buildings saya nampak kat, yeah, certain countries tu last for the many hundreds of years, yeah. Yeah, it can be durable, yeah. Attractivity, yeah, kita tahu the estate dia ada in terms of location dia unique, yeah, the building and also financing probably, yeah. And this makes pricing difficult, increases search cost, create information asymmetry and greatly restrict accessibility. You tak boleh nak tukar one to the other. And also we know that the market is typically divided into residential, commercial, industrial segment, yeah. And nothing. Sekarang dah ada mixed-use development, yeah. To try to, kau tak tahu nanti Google, ya, business development apa dia, ya. Because that is actually increasingly being developed, ya, especially in where land is scarce, where land tak banyak lagi tinggal, ya. high cost transaction, okay, no, there's apa, sudah banyak fee yang termasuk, then dia kita nak buat apa transaction in apa property, yeah, it's something that you have got to know what would be the cost involved, yeah, SMD involved here, and can also have long time delays, yeah, for it to happen, yeah, so because macam supply of apa to a particular location. So sekarang people have question the property market. There is currently an oversupply katanya. Okay, yeah, in certain location tu ni. Yeah, especially because Napik punya study, there is actually currently oversupply of affordable housing in some location or low cost housing in some location. Tapi tempat tu are not accessible. Siapa nak beli? Yeah, although is the price is less. Yeah. Because you can't take transportation to work ataupun, you know, to anywhere. Kalau dia terletak di tempat-tempat yang, you know, terpencil dan sebagainya, ya. Yeah. And also, time lag ni, kenapa kita kalau macam supply tak cukup, bukan kita. It's going to take try to be sort of completed, ya, yeah, to be given to the demand. Chain, ya. Yeah. So something kita punya ni, there can be some lag, ya, yeah, of the discussion in the demand and supply lah, lebih kurang, ya, yeah, because to meet up the demand of your potential customer. It can be both investment or consumption good, ya, yeah, because kadang bila kita expect return, it becomes an investment good. Kalau kita use it for own purposes, menggunakan consumption good or both, ya. Yeah. It depends, ya, yeah, siapa, kenapa dia membeli, ya, yeah, that apa, particular property. Mobility, memang tak boleh nak bergerak lah, ya, yeah, unless mobile home tu lain lah, ya, yeah, okay. Okay, that is apa, so something which kita kena tengok kalau special facility lah, ha, maknanya dia fix to a particular location. Nah, you can just make adjustment by kan moving your house here and there, that property here and there. Okay, there are two broad categories of property. Okay, tahu ni juga memang kita semua tahu, ya, yeah, apa being developed by developer, ya, yeah, and also purchasers can apa acquire and apa dapat the property after the completion of construction and signing the sales and purchase agreement, ya, yeah, depending on the time frame, yeah, for landed or for certified properties, ya. Yeah. Okay, tahu Malaysian government trying to encourage developer to build and sell, ya, yeah, which means that they will complete construction baru buat selling, yeah, but not in the case of apalah, ya, yeah, kita di Malaysia, because developers would not have the apalah daya tahan, ya, yeah, to apa ni, because it involves a lot of capital, ya, yeah. But sekarang purchaser what they do that before the house being completed, pasti dalam construction you pay just down 10% punya payment, ya, yeah. Existing property, okay, can purchase second hand after purchase the property, ya. Yeah. Yang ada, you pay down payment, and then you pay your ni lah, the remaining, provided you get apa your loan, ya, being apa ni, bila time. Tapi hopefully be advised, ya, yeah, by your siapa lah, ya, lawyer as well as your agent, ya, yeah, tentang the time frame given to pay the rest of the outstanding balance. Saya pernah kena jugalah, ya, yeah, because these are some of things that you need. Hope to be aware of, yeah, because sometimes bila you buy this property, you kena get some necessary state approval, yeah, untuk di apa dilepaskan daripada restriction dalam title tersebut, yeah. So make sure you know everything and do a proper title check. I think you all, as property students, you all should be able to identify that. Okay, that's it, yeah. So jap, yeah. Saya punya komputer ni. Sorry. Tak ada. Dia dah. Ini tempat lain dia lari pula dah. It's my certificate je. Sorry, ya, you on. Dia dah buat masalah juga. Okay. So that's it, ya. Yeah. Sekarang ni saya tak nak bombard you all with apa ni. Too many apa information, ya, for the first class. go to, kalau tak ada, tak sempat tu, try to go to my apa recording nanti lepas ni. Yeah. Hopefully get some apa lah, kalau dapat read through some of the apa information and apa ni tentang marketing, do that. Yeah. Actually it's a very interesting topic sebenarnya. Yeah. To know more. Yeah. Kalau kita apa, kita ingat tu lah, senang je marketing ni. Yeah. Padahal pemahaman tu memerlukan banyak lagi ya, artinya konsep yang kita perlu tahu ya. Okey, ada apa-apa soalan tak? Soalan tak? Rasanya boleh ya. How about a start of what marketing is, ya? Hopefully you are able to ni. Okay, boleh? If not, ya, mungkin saya tak dengar ya.
Boleh,
doktor. Boleh. Boleh ya. Okay, sure. Okay, do apa the best you can. Okay, go to and try to understand. Kalau dapat buku, baca. Because me, when I went to Professor Kotler punya buku, I was very interested to know more what marketing actually is all about. Because buku dia interesting, ada banyak case study dan sebagainya, kan? Yeah? Yang dia ada. Okay, cuma itulah, because of the online thing, ya. Yeah? Things have moved so fast, yeah. So we must keep up with what is there for us to use as tools to assist us in doing the selling in the marketing punya perspective, yeah. Because itulah, kita kan besok kita ada belajar strategi later on. We will go through how to strategize, yeah, for us to do the selling part, yeah. The selling is just one part, yeah. But doing marketing is a lot more for you to do more, yeah. Okay, so. So hopefully I'll be, insyaAllah, I'll be meeting you all tomorrow, yeah, at 11 o'clock, yeah, and I'll be sharing with you lah, maybe soalan apa ni, assignment, and maybe ada some questions that maybe I'm going to post, and you all be able to try to, apa ni, saya dah letak kot soalan dalam spectrum, try to see whether you are able to, apa, go through the question, kita tengok macam mana, yeah. And then I will explain to you also, ya, yeah, kita punya arrangement of the tutorial punya session, ya. Yeah. Okay, so that's it, ya. Yeah. I'll be meeting you all tomorrow. Kalau tak ada apa-apa, there anything you all like today?
No.
Ada apa-apa? Tak ada?
No.
No, ya. Yeah? Okay, then I'll see you all tomorrow, ya. Yeah? Boleh?
Doctor, okay. The tutorial question should be hanging before the class.
Masa kelas tu nanti we'll have some discussion, boleh? Tak apa, because kalau saya tak dapat attend the tutorial, I ask you to apa tu submit. Tidak, I'll meet you all again tomorrow. Ya, yeah? Kita buat discussion tomorrow. But go through the question lah ya, yeah? Yang saya dah letak.
Okay. Yeah? Okay. Doktor, so maksudnya after discussion baru kami handing kami punya answer.
Boleh, yes, can. Okay, sure. And by the way, make sure that you all click into your attendance, yeah, dekat Spectrum. Kalau siapa ada masalah, just apa, just tell me tomorrow. Yeah, because I'm trying to test and see what Spectrum is capturing, yeah, with the attendance and whatnot. Yeah. Okay, see you all tomorrow.